Imagine that you have a class called rectangle and another called square. Which is a subtype of which? Is square a subtype of rectangle, or is rectangle a subtype of square? This is the infamous square-rectangle problem, also known as the circle-ellipse problem. Now, in mathematics, a square is a special type of a rectangle. So it might seem reasonable that in programming, we should structure it the same way. So square would be a subtype of rectangle, or square would inherit from rectangle. But in object-oriented programming, this can lead to some very unexpected behavior. Let's explore this with some code, but let's first define the goal. We're looking for two classes. One should be called rectangle, and one should be called square. When we change the width or height of an object of type rectangle, we only want the width or height to change, respectively. But if we change the width or height of an object of type square, then we want the object's width and height to change to whatever number we're setting to, so that width is always equal to height. Alright, so that's the goal, and the question we're asking is which of these two classes is a subtype of the other? Let's start by defining rectangle like this. We've got a class called rectangle, and it has two properties. One property is called width, and the other property is called height. We're marking them as virtual to allow them to be overridden in subclasses, because now we're exploring the idea of letting rectangle be the superclass and square to be the subclass. And we initialize both of these properties to 1, so that when you instantiate a rectangle, you end up with an object with a width of 1 and a height of 1. Okay, this of course is fine, and you can use it like this. I'll declare a variable called rect of type rectangle, and inside of that variable, I'll put a new rectangle. We're instantiating a rectangle. Of course, that rectangle would have a size of 1 times 1, a width of 1, and a height of 1. But you can of course then use these properties on this variable called rect that contains a rectangle. So you would say rect.width, for example, rect.width equals 3. And that means that we would change the width of that rectangle to 3. But, of course, we would not change the height, because it's a rectangle, it's not a square. So that means after doing this, we end up with a rectangle whose width is 3 and whose height is 1, because the height remains whatever we set it to from the start. Okay, let's now define square as a class that inherits from rectangle, but without overriding anything. Like here, we're saying now there's a class called square that inherits from rectangle, but there are no overrides. It basically just inherits everything. Now, this is a silly implementation, I know, because of course this won't behave like a square, but just bear with me for the sake of illustration. If we would use this class, it would look something like this. We would say, let's declare a variable called square of type square and assign it a new square. So we're instantiating a square and we're putting it inside of a variable that we call square. Now, what happens if we now change the size of this square using these public properties width and height? So I'll say square.width is equal to 3, because square hasn't overridden and changed the implementation of the members as they were defined in rectangle. Nothing special happens. We get exactly the same behavior as we had before. We end up with a shape that's 3 in width and 1 in height. It essentially behaves like a rectangle. When we're changing width, we're only changing width and we're not changing height. So suddenly we have a class that's called square, but that doesn't behave like a square at all, which of course violates the idea of a square, the contract of a square. So of course this is not the solution. So let's drop this idea and instead try to override width and height in square. What would that look like? Well, it might look something like this. You have a class called square that inherits from rectangle, and now we define two private fields. One is called width and one is called height, because these fields will hold the actual data. And now we override the properties width and height and give a new implementation. So these are now computed properties because they're interacting with these private fields. And by the way, I've only written out the implementation for width, and I've put dot 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 here for height, because it's essentially the same thing but reflected for height. And so what's the implementation that we're doing? What's the key point here? Well, when you're getting the width, we're just fetching whatever is in the private field width. Simple behavior. But whenever someone is trying to change the width, to set the width, or the height, but to set the width, then we are doing something special. Then we are not only changing the private field width, but we are also changing the private field height. We are changing both of them. Here, right? We're saying width is equal to value and height is equal to value, whatever value was passed in. So that when we're doing something like width equals 3, we're not only changing the width, but we're also changing the height. As per the definition of a square, right? And again, same thing for the property height. So does this work? Yes, as a square, but not as a rectangle. We are now violating the contract of a rectangle. Why? What does that mean? Why do we say that we are violating the contract of a rectangle? Isn't this a square? Well, our class square behaves like a square, but it doesn't also behave like a rectangle. And because we've said that square inherits from rectangle, it becomes a subtype of rectangle, so it becomes substitutable for rectangles, which means that it must also behave like a rectangle. At any point in your code, if you're expecting a rectangle, you should be able to give a square. Squares should be substitutable for rectangles. It should be possible to use squares instead of rectangles. But it's not, because we're violating the contract, the idea of what it means to be a rectangle. Look at these lines here in the bottom. We're declaring a variable called rect of type rectangle, of the supertype. And to that variable, we're assigning an object of type square, the subtype. And then we are changing the width. Now, of course, because we have a square, what's gonna happen is we're gonna end up with 3 times 3. The variable rect will have a width of 3 and a height of 3, because the variable rect points to an object of type square. And the implementation of width in square is that it changes both the width and the height. Both the width and the height. So as we're accessing the property width of the rect variable and we're setting it to 3, we're changing both the width and the height to 3. What is the problem? The problem is that we can upcast objects of type square to rectangle. So objects of type square can be used in places where we expect objects of type rectangle. Squares can be used instead of rectangles. And when we perform this upcasting, we forget about all the details. We forget about the fact that it happened to be a square. Yes, here we know that it's a square. But here we no longer know that it's a square. All we know is that it's any possible object that can be treated as a rectangle. Could be a square, could be a rectangle. We don't know. All we know is that it's something that claims that it's a rectangle. In terms of terminology, the runtime type is square, but the compile time type is rectangle. And we need to respect the contract of the compile time type. So that's the question, right? Do our objects of type square behave like rectangles? Do they respect the idea, the contract of rectangle? Let's try it out. Let's use this as an example. We take rect and we change the width to 3. But as we said, what will be the consequence of this is that width will be changed to 3, but height will also be changed to 3, because we're now using the implementation of square. But that does not jive with, is not consistent with, the idea of a rectangle. So if you forget about the right-hand side here, if you only consider the left-hand side here, all you know is that you have something of type rectangle. If all you know is that you have something of type rectangle, you would expect that when you change the width, the height would not change. You would expect just the width to be changed. Because that's also the idea that we had in the beginning when we said, wait, let's first define what the goal is. So clearly, this doesn't work because we're violating the idea of a rectangle. And now you might say, but how could you end up in a situation where you put a square inside of a rectangle and forget that you had a square? Well, I mean, this is the whole point of polymorphism and upcasting and dynamic dispatch. Just imagine this. You have a method that accepts objects of type rectangle. You have no idea what people will send you. You might get a rectangle, you might get a square, you might get any object that can be treated as a rectangle. So it really matters what the idea of a rectangle is. And it really matters if someone violates that idea and behaves differently. Because if you think that you have something where width is independent from height and suddenly it's not, then you'd be surprised. And hence the original point about how all of this might cause very unexpected behavior. So maybe the solution is that rectangle should be a subtype of square. Try it out on your own. Essentially, we'll end up with the same problem, but in reverse. Essentially, we can't define a subtype relationship between rectangle and square because the two ideas are fundamentally at odds with each other, are fundamentally in conflict with each other. They want width and height to behave in fundamentally different ways, where one is not a superset of the other idea. So what is the takeaway? If we want the properties width and height to be mutable, changeable, settable, then we can't establish a subtype relationship between these two types. But so here's a question for you. What if we don't want to change width and height? What if we make width and height read-only? What if this is not a mutable type? What if width and height is only set upon construction? Can we establish a subtyping relationship then? Try it out and let us know your conclusions in the comments. The more general takeaway is that this is a case of a violation of the principle known as Liskov's substitution principle. And Liskov's substitution principle helps us ensure that an instance of a subtype always can be used where an instance of its supertype is expected without causing any unexpected behavior, without leading to bugs that are hard to find. So the next step would clearly be to understand the Liskov substitution principle in detail. But more about that in another video. Subscribe.